So far I was giving you lectures on how to do data scraping through Excel VBA. Now I am going to teach you another shortcut by which you can do full scraping through JavaScript or maybe partially through JavaScript and do rest of the scraping through Excel VBA. The tip that I am going to teach you is make things easier for you while doing data scraping, because the ultimate goal is to get the data, doesn't matter what way we are choosing to get the data. Okay, so this is the website which has a lot of products on the page, and on every page if we click on this view details button, we'll see some details. Now the task is to extract all the details for all these products. So first of all, what we need to do is we need to open developer tools and click on this element section. We need to inspect the element which we require to get the information. So we actually need to click on this button. So for this button, we see here it is having a href, which is the length for every product. Now for all such elements, we would be having these elements in the HTML and we would be requiring their length basically. So once we have all the links, we can navigate through all the links one by one through VBA and then extract the information which we need. To reduce the step of getting all the links even through VBA, what we can do is, we can see here that the property of this element is, it is having anchor tag with class button view BFFV. So let us first of all search this element using CSS selector. So a dot button dot we use for class names, and since the element is having four classes, so button.view.b.ffv, this tells us that we have 356 elements on the page. Okay, so we copy this CSS selector, we go to console window, and then here if we want to print all the elements that we have selected using the selector, what we can do is document.query selector all, and in single quotes or probably in double quotes you can put the selector, and then you will get the list of elements. Okay, so what you can do is you can store the list of elements in a variable e, right? Next step is to iterate through all these elements from I equals 0 till we reach to length of the elements and then increment by 1. Okay, and in this for loop, what we are going to do is we are going to print the href property of all these elements one by one. So we are going to actually write all the content on document itself. So document.write e index I dot href, concatenate it with a new line. Now if we enter, we have list of all the URLs, all the 356 URLs which we actually need. Okay, now we can go to Excel and then we can paste all these URLs in Excel sheet. Okay, now we have all these URLs. The URLs start from row number 3, let's say, and go up to 358. So we can go to VB editor and then we can create a module. And then we can add references like we were doing data scraping for other websites. So we'll import Microsoft HTML object library and Microsoft Internet Controls. This one and this one. Okay, so dem IE as Internet Explorer. Dem HT as HTML document, set IE equals new Internet Explorer, ie.visible equals to ie.navigate. Here we need to give URL. So URL is basically coming from a cell. So for that we'll use a for loop. For I equals 3, which is the starting row, up to 358, which is the last row. Next, and URL is coming from cells I comma 1 dot value. Okay, so this is IE. So we are navigating to the page, and then we need to wait for the page to load. So do while IE dot ready state is not equals ready state complete loop do events. Okay, so we are waiting for page to load. Once the loading is complete, what we can do is we need to extract the information. Here we need to write logic to extract information. So again, for that what we do is we go to our website, we open one of the pages. Now let's say we want to extract the name. So we inspect the element and we see here the class of this element is IC show hide RP UU, and we need to extract first paragraph of it. So we go to VBA code, and then after initializing the browser and then navigating to that page, and after page load, what we can do is set HT to IE.document, and then we can point to that object. So HT.getElementsByClassName. And this is the class. If we search element by this class, if I put div dot ic dot show hide underscore rp dot uu, it gives us two elements. The first one is for this block and the second one is for this block. So we are talking about second block. First one has index 0, second one has index 1. So therefore I put 1 here and then dot get elements by tag name with tag p. And again, if I go back here, you can see we have two paragraphs under it, but we are talking about the first one. So for first one I put index 0 and then dot inner text. So that is what we need, and I put this, I print this value here in console. So debug dot print like this. Okay, so let us put a breakpoint here and run the code. So it opens the website, it reaches to that page. And when I pass over to the statement, it prints the name. So if you have any question in this context, please feel free to write to me in the comment section. And also do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the like button. Thank you. We'll see you in the next tutorial.